Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This video I am going to talk about compliance, how to measure and how to calculate. Before we start, we usually do some sort of maneuvers. This is expiratory hold, or we put an expiratory pause. What are the waves we read? Is the pressure time curve, flow time curve, volume time curve, esophageal pressure time curve, transalveolar pressure time curve. So this is a compliance. What's meant by compliance? It is a change in volume that occurs per unit change in pressure. Change in volume per unit change in pressure. Pulmonary compliance is defined as the change in lung volume per unit change in pressure. So it is milli per centimeter water. The formula we measure it is this is a pressure equals volume over the compliance. This is a volume, this is the tidal volume of the compliance. What's the pressure? This delta pressure. It is the change from expiration to inspiration. This delta change, it is a change from transient expiration to transient expiration, or it is transient inspiration minus transient expiration. What this? Look at these other pressures we usually measure. Here, transrespiratory pressure. The pressure, alveolar pressure or airway pressure minus atmospheric pressure. This is measured during inspiration minus expiration to go for the calculations of the total compliance of the respiratory system, total compliance. Compliance of the lung plus compliance of the chest wall. Again, this is the transrespiratory airway pressure or alveolar pressure minus atmospheric pressure during inspiration and the same measurement during expiration. When we come to the transpulmonary or transalveolar pressure, this is a pressure, alveolar pressure minus esophageal pressure or pleural pressure. First, during inspiration minus during expiration. So this is what we call transalveolar pressure. This is transalveolar pressure. Airway pressure or esophageal pressure. This minus this. This is transalveolar pressure, transpulmonary pressure. This is for the measurement of the compliance of the lung itself alone. When it comes to this pressure, transthoracic pressure, this is the difference between pleural pressure or esophageal pressure we measure minus barometric pressure. The first during inspiration minus during expiration. This is for the measurement of chest wall compliance. So the total compliance, this we measure, this is transrespiratory, airway pressure or labial pressure minus barometric pressure. Transalveolar or transpulmonary, this is airway pressure minus esophageal pressure. During inspiration minus during expiration. And this is transthoracic pressure, esophageal pressure minus barometric pressure during inspiration minus during expiration. So the respiratory compliance is the total compliance will equal this is the tidal volume over the pressure, which pressure? Transrespiratory pressure at the end of inspiration, which means plateau pressure minus barometric pressure. Minus transrespiratory pressure at the end of expiration, which means PEPA minus the barometric pressure. And the final, this is the formula, will be this is the respiratory compliance, which is the total compliance of the chest wall and the lung equals the tidal volume over the plateau pressure minus PEPA. This is the formula, final formula. When we come to the lung compliance, this is a tidal volume over what? Over we said transalveolar pressure during inspiration minus transalveolar pressure during expiration. Chest wall compliance equals the tidal volume over the esophageal pressure during inspiration minus esophageal pressure during expiration. Compliance is the change in volume per unit, chamber unit change in pressure. This is the formula, ml per centimeter water. Normally the total compliance is not like that symbol equals compliance of lung plus compliance of chest wall. No, it is one of the total compliance. 1 over total compliance equals 1 over lung compliance plus 1 over chest wall compliance. If the compliance of the lung is 200 and compliance of the chest wall is 200, this means 1 over 200 plus 1 over 200 to give you 2 over 200, which means 1 over 100. This means that the total compliance will be 100. So if the compliance of the lung is 200 and that of the chest wall is 200, the compliance, the total compliance of the two will be 100, not 400. Okay? We can calculate it. This is the total compliance equals the compliance of the lung multiplied by the compliance of the chest wall over compliance of the lung plus compliance of the chest wall. Elastance is the reverse. Elastance is change in pressure, but unit change in volume. So it is a centimeter water per liter. And here the total elastance of the respiratory system, which equals that of the lung and that of the chest wall. Compliance equals 1 over elastance, or the compliance itself, this is it is 1,000 over compliance to give you the elastance. Let's go and see the examples. This is a compliance. If the compliance of the respiratory system is 100, how much is the elastance? It will be 1,000 over 100, it will be 10. Compliance 200 of the respiratory system, how much is the elastance of this respiratory system? Will be 1,000 over 200 to give you 5 centimeter water per liter. An example, when the lung compliance is 150, chest wall compliance is 200, how much? The total compliance, 1 over the total equals 1 over 150 plus 1 over 200, or the compliance will, total compliance equals the lung compliance multiplied by chest compliance over lung plus chest wall, give you this number. Let's come and measure it. The first thing you said, we'll give you, we'll make expiratory hold. Expiratory hold, this is an expiratory, this is a, we'll make an expiratory hold for 3 to 5 seconds, and this is a, and this will give you, this is the beep during the time, no flow, no volume. And this is a transalveolar pressure during expirations, and this is also esophageal pressure during expiration. So what we measure from the expiratory hold, this is a beep, this is the transalveolar pressure during expiration, and the esophageal pressure during that, that's it. This is a beep 20, transalveolar pressure 3.1, this is measured here, and the esophageal pressure 17.4. Come to the inspiratory hold. Inspiratory hold, this is an inspiratory hold, 3 to 5 seconds, and this is the blood pressure, no flow, this is the tidal volume, this is the transalveolar pressure during inspiration, this is the esophageal pressure during inspiration, these are the data. Okay? Right. Let's come and calculate. This is the data of the expiratory hold, beep and transalveolar pressure during expiration, and this is the data from the inspiratory hold, blood pressure, transalveolar pressure during inspiration, tidal volume, esophageal pressure during inspiration, and this is the beep. Okay, let's calculate the respiratory compliance equals the tidal volume over the beep, the blood pressure minus beep, blood pressure minus beep. This will give you, this is the compliance. What's under the over compliance? This compliance will give you the elastance. When it comes to the compliance of the lung, this is the tidal volume over the transalveolar pressure during inspiration minus transalveolar pressure during expiration. This is, as I said, give you the compliance of the lung. One side of the over this number give you the elastance of the lung. When it comes to the compliance of chest wall, this is the tidal volume over the esophageal pressure during inspiration minus esophageal pressure during expiration. This is the number. This will give you, this is the number of the compliance, and this is 1,000 of this will give you the elastance. For sure, this is the elastance, and the total elastance here. Total elastance, how much? 32. The elastance of the lung, this is the elastance of the lung, 23. And the elastance of the chest wall, So we are true and we are correct. Another example, this is expiratory hole. Expiratory hole, this is esophageal pressure. This is a beep. And this is a transalveolar pressure during expiration. These are the that. Come to the respiratory hole. This is the esophageal pressure. This is the blood two pressure. This is the tidal volume. This is the transalveolar pressure. These are the that. Again, come, this is expiratory hold, this is the data of the expiratory hold, this is the data of the respiratory hold, the compliance of the respiratory system, tidal volume, this is the tidal volume, our what, our the blood two pressure, minus B, this is the blood two pressure, minus B. This gives you the, this is the compliance, and this is the one third of this number will give you the essence. When you come to the compliance of the lung, this is the compliance of the lung, will be this is the tidal volume of our transalveolar pressure, the transalveolar pressure during inspiration, transalveolar pressure during inspiration minus transalveolar pressure during expiration, inspiration, expiration. This gives you the, this is the compliance of the lung. One center of it will give you, this is the elastance. When you come to the compliance chest wall, this chest wall, this is the tidal volume, subgel pressure during inspiration, minus the subgel pressure during expiration, that's it. Give you the, this is the compliance of the lung, of the chest wall. One thousand of it will give you the elastance chest wall. The same formula, when you come, this is the total elastance or respiratory equal this the lung plus the chest wall. I think it's easy. Thank you very much.